Well, after years of issues, the Defence Force has announced Australia's Taipan helicopters will now be permanently grounded.
Since their introduction in 2007, the aircraft experienced several major safety issues.
Most recently, four crew members lost their lives when a Taipan crashed near Hamilton Island during training exercises in July. I spoke to the Defence Minister, Richard Marles, a short time ago. What information? We have families desperate for information about what happened to their loved ones. You've said that you won't finger point. They said there were problems with the aircraft, and now you're grounding them. You are saying these aircraft are not safe. Why weren't they those decisions made before we sent those four officers into the air?
Well, Carl, look, we need to be really clear and careful in terms of how we are describing all of this, and that's what I'm being. The moment that this incident occurred, we said we would not fly the helicopters again until investigations were completed, that we understood what had happened, and that if there was any rectifications that needed to be made, they had been made. Now, since then, what's become clear is that those investigations are going to take a considerable amount of time. One of the four has already indicated that it will be 12 months before that investigation is complete.
All right, let's bring in Davina Smith, the wife of an air crewman who flies in the Army and a Nine presenter. Davina, we've spoken to you about this in the past. Today's breaking news. How has that been dealt by with the family?
I saw the news this morning and I burst into tears. My husband's flying these aircraft for a number of years in Black Hawk before that. We've known since 2007 that there have been issues with these aircraft. And I speak as a wife, and I know there are husbands, wives, mothers, fathers, sons and daughters who have family members flying these aircraft who have been terrified that an incident would happen. I applaud Richard Marles for finally making that decision that no Defence Minister up until this point has had the guts to do, but it shouldn't have taken an accident and four lives lost to come to this point.
And that was my point to him, that how did we get to the point where these aircraft are now grounded, how did we get to the point where they were flying after so many problems.
And the point needs to be made, we still don't know what happened in the Hamilton Island crash. But before Hamilton Island, there was the Jervis Bay crash in March this year. That was only a few months ago. We still don't know why that happened and when that happened. The report surrounding that hasn't been publicly released. There has been no transparency regarding this, and that is no comfort to a wife like me whose husband flies in these aircraft, and it's no comfort to anyone else.
So where does your emotion come from?
From the fact that these aircraft were not wanted by the Army back in 2007, back in the year 2000 when they were first looked at. This has been a politically motivated decision the whole way through. Time and time again, there have been warnings and there have been reasons to ground these aircraft. They cost too much to fly, and we're talking about major safety issues. They're not little nuts and bolts. They're cracked windscreens, their tail rotors falling off, their engine failures. We don't know what happened in Hamilton Island, but there were enough warning signs up to this point to know that they should have been grounded. And I have been so scared as a wife, knowing my husband is in that aircraft. And it is a testament to the men and women who fly these aircraft, to their skill and their abilities, that up until this point we haven't had an accident, because they are so good, they have been flying what has been a faulty aircraft.
And Davina, your husband knows these two of the men who died in his crash.
He taught Alex, who was an instructor, and Phil was an incredibly wonderful mentor to Mark. He also knew Diesel and Max, the two pilots. They are incredible, wonderful men. Two of them have children. Those families are mourning at the moment. And if I could use this chance to plug, the Commando Welfare Trust is fundraising at the moment to support those families. They'll pay for the kids' education in the future. But you're looking at the faces of four extraordinary men who are part of a team in the 6th Aviation Unit in Holsworthy in Sydney, who are the very best of the best flyers. They are grieving at the moment. And they don't deserve this uncertainty surrounding an aircraft that's existed not for the last few months, but for the last decade.
Just finally, you touched on how it was for you to have your husband flying an aircraft, and you, who knows what might have happened. For these families, does this give them any comfort, or does it add to the anger and frustration and desire for information?
I've been in contact with these families. That they're wonderful people. I can't speak for them. That's their story to tell. But I know as a wife, knowing that that aircraft, that a Taipan will never fly in Australia again, that gives me some peace of mind. I know my husband is safe.
Good on you, Davina. Thank you so much. Lovely to see you.
Sorry.
Don't be sorry. It's heartbreaking. This is the thing. I mean,
it shouldn't have happened. Okay. Four lives shouldn't have been lost.
Yeah. All right.
Exactly.
That says it all. Well, the breaking news. Australia's Taipan helicopters will not return to flying operations before their planned withdrawal date of 2024. This announcement follows a series of major issues with the aircraft. Most recently, four crew members died after a Taipan crashed into the sea near Hamilton Island during military exercises. We remember the pain of that. Deputy Prime Minister Richard Marles joins us now. Richard, good morning to you. Thank you for your time. That's the decision this morning.
It is, and it's really the only decision that makes sense. We had made clear that we wouldn't be flying these aircraft again until the investigations were completed, that we understood what had happened and we'd made any rectifications that needed to occur. There are now four investigations on foot. Already one of them's made clear that it will take 12 months for them to reach their conclusion. And we were planning to retire the Taipans at the end of next year anyway. And so there is no world should be flying these helicopters again. And given that, what we really need to do is to be moving as quickly as we can to have our new capability, the Black Hawks, stood up as soon as possible, and that's really our focus. So we're making this decision today. In many ways, it was inevitable, but it's an important step to take so that we can get our Black Hawks in the air as quickly as possible.
In the difficult weeks following that awful crash, you were on the record as saying to us that there would be no fingers pointing here at anyone in particular or anything. But it's clear this morning when you made this announcement that you are.
Well, we will be doing investigations, and when I say that, both Commonwealth government agencies and indeed the Queensland coroner, and all of those investigations will look to understand as completely as possibly exactly what's happened here.
But you're grounding,
and what
you're
lessons
grounding
need
the fleet.
To be learned.
You're grounding
so
the
in
fleet. You're absolutely saying they can't be in the air.
Well, the fleet was grounded at the time of the incident, and we did that on the very day. I mean, there was no... We made that decision at the time, and when we made that decision, we made clear that we would not be flying the helicopters again until investigations were complete and that we understood what had happened.
Richard,
were planning to retire the helicopters at the end of this year anyway, end of next year anyway.
What information do you have now? That you didn't have before we sent those four soldiers into the air?
Well, the information that we have now is fundamentally the duration of the investigations that are taking place. So there are four investigations that will take place. Sorry, Carl.
What information? We have families desperate for information about what happened to their loved ones. You've said that you won't fingerpoint. They said there were problems with the aircraft, and now you're grounding them. You are saying these aircraft are not safe. Why weren't those decisions made before we sent those four officers into the air?
Well, Carl, we need to be really clear and careful in terms of how we are describing all of this, and that's what I'm being. The moment that this incident occurred, we said we would not fly the helicopters again until investigations were completed, that we understood what had happened, and that if there was any rectifications that needed to be made, they had been made. Now, since then, what's become clear is that those investigations are going to take a considerable amount of time. One of the four has already indicated that it will be 12 months before that investigation is complete. These airframes were not intended to be used beyond the end of 2024. In those circumstances, it is now impossible to see a scenario where we would complete the investigations, have the recommendations in place, implement those recommendations, and then be flying these aircraft for, a few weeks at the end of next year. It makes no sense.
I'm sorry.
And so on that basis, Carl, what we are doing is making the decision that we really need need to be getting the new capability into the air as quickly as possible, and that is the Black Hawks, a decision that we had taken prior to this incident occurring. You asked the question, yeah. What do we now know? But if I can finish, Carl, what do we now know that we didn't? What we now know is the duration of these investigations and the fact that given the conditions that we said at the moment that this occurred, there is now no scenario where we would be flying these helicopters again. And that's why we're making the decision that we've made today.
It just doesn't make any sense to me that I don't know how. I'm sorry for my tone. I feel genuinely, genuinely sorry for the families of those defence personnel. And if I'm sitting there and I'm one of their family members, and you're saying to me, the very helicopters that my loved ones went up in, crashed, took their lives, can no longer fly anymore, I don't know how you explain that to them.
Well, I mean, I don't know how to do it more clearly than the way in which I've just done it. We don't yet know what occurred on that night. We don't. Those investigations are still underway. Carl, we're still recovering the actual airframe from the bottom of the Whitsundays. That is still in process now. It is in a really difficult place to recover.
I understand.
So there is a whole lot more work which needs to be done to understand what had happened. And we're not prejudging what has happened here. That is work that needs to occur. But there is a practical reality now, which is that the investigations that are underway are going to take a year. And in circumstances where we had planned to retire this airframe at the end of next year anyway, there is no scenario left anymore where we can imagine that those airframe are going to fly again. Now, we need to be making sure that the capability of being of having helicopters is up and running as quickly as possible. We need to move to the next capability, which is the Black Hawks. Again, a decision that we had made prior to this incident occurring is in place as quickly as possible. Making today allows us to do that.
But just again, trying to explain this to families who have lost loved ones, you're saying that essentially these aircraft are now grounded because an investigation is going to take too long. That does not in any way appease the hurt, frustration and anger they would feel towards a department that has what now are deemed unsafe aircraft in the sky.
Again, Carl, I haven't said too long. I've just said it is going to take this amount of time. It will take the time that it takes. I have spoken with the families. I have spoken with the families this week. And so they are aware of the processes which are in place here. And I can tell you this, Carl, no one who is involved in this in any way wants to see speculation or people jump to conclusions. They just want the process undertaken in a way where we actually thoroughly get the answers that we need to get in relation to this.
Okay.
Now, those answers yesterday, but we can't, we need to do the work that needs to be done order to get the actual answers happened here.
We're running out of time.
That's what we're doing.
We're running out of time. Just finally, it's going to be a fairly significant hole in our arsenal. I mean, how long are you rushing forward the replacements? What's the time frame on that?
Yeah, I mean, there is a challenge in relation to capability, and again, that's why we're making the decision that we're making today. We already have three Black Hawks in the country now. The first of those took its first flight in the last week. But there are going to be challenges around a capability gap here, and that's why we're working with our international partners, particularly the United States, particularly to get more time for aircrew to train so that they can be certified on the Black Hawk as quickly as possible. But this decision is actually all about getting those Black Hawks flying as quickly as we can.
Richard, thanks for your time. Appreciate it.